So the basic unit of a storyboard is a panel, and it's defined by a white rectangle, both in the thumbnail view as well as in the timeline view. So panels describe actions, and an action can be something as subtle as the change of expression on a character's face. You can use as many panels as necessary to describe an action. So panels are housed or grouped together in these gray backgrounds, otherwise known as a scene or a shot. In Storyboard Pro, if you have your terminology settings set to animation, these gray backgrounds will be described as scenes, whereas if you're using the live action terminology, they'll be described as shots. So as you may have noticed, they alternate between dark gray and light gray, both in the thumbnail view as well as in the timeline view. So we see here dark gray, light gray, dark gray, light gray. So scenes or shots begin and end when there is a camera angle change. And in animation, this makes a lot of sense because every time the camera angle changes, the painted background needs to change. The same goes for live action. In live action, a shot can be defined as when the camera cuts from a long shot to a close-up. So scenes or shots are grouped by this blue background, otherwise known as a sequence. And we can once again see that in the timeline view as well. Sequences are defined by these blue bars. And a sequence groups panels or scenes that occur in the same location. So for example, here we have action occurring outside of a spaceship out in outer space, and then we move to the interior of the spaceship. So all of these next scenes or shots take place within the interior of that spaceship. The last or topmost level in the storyboarding hierarchy are acts. And acts are defined by these pink-purple brackets in the thumbnail view, as well as by this pink-purple flag in the timeline view. And acts are defined by a change in the story arc of a story.